Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to dive into a fun CTF challenge where we'll be retrieving a flag.txt file from a server using the powerful command line tool netcat. And this challenge involves exploiting a potential vulnerability on the server. So please remember to use this knowledge responsibly and ethically. So as you can see, I'm here, already started the challenge. This is our target IP. We copy that. First, we will try to see what's going on this application. Yeah, so we have two stickers here. Check the source code. Sorry. Let's see if we can find something interesting here. Nothing. We have an input field here. Try HTML injection here. See if it's vulnerable or not. Thanks for your feedback. It will be evaluated shortly by us. Okay, so what I'm going to do here, I'm planning to insert a script in the input field. So afterwards, when the script I'm gonna go on the server, I'll retrieve the flag using netcat. So. So I'm going to use the script, and I will drop the script in the description down below as well. Let's use it. And wait, let me set the port here. I'll go for 994. You guys can choose any port you want to listen on. Already copied this, but let me do it again for you guys. So everything looks good here. Let me replace the target IP address, which is 10.10.124.131. It's on port 88. Let me set up the netcat here. Port 994. It's listening on 994. Let's submit the request. Okay. Let's go there. It's not working. Let me try it again. It's not working. Uh, Okay. So yeah, here we go. Get the flag. Let's go to the website. Submit our flag. So congratulations. We have successfully exploited the blind XSS vulnerability here and retrieved the flag.txt file. And guys, remember this technique should only be used for authorized penetration testing and ethical security research. As you can see, this challenge highlights the importance of proper input validation and sanitization to prevent XSS attacks. I hope this video was informative and helpful. And for the remediation, always sanitize user inputs and escaping special characters like opening bracket and double bracket, closing bracket, I mean. At the same time, double quote to prevent script injections. Ensure sensitive files like flag.txt are not really, directly accessible. And a bonus tip, obviously, use server-side and client-side libraries to detect and filter XSS payloads. So that's it for today. Thank you.